Do not take your college experiences for granted. Everybody that you meet is either for a reason, or it has a reason behind it, or it's a lesson to be learned. Always keep thriving to do your best. And definitely, if you are in a situation that is not in your favor, look at the ways you can get out of that situation and use it to your best ability.
It feels good, honestly. It feels great. I can't wait to hold that diploma in my hand and be like, I made it. Like, and take selfies with my professors. Because they won't take selfies with us until we graduate, you know?
Being a senior, I do not know how I feel to be a senior yet. Even though I am a senior, I always had the leadership role, so people already looked at me as if I was like some sort of senior, like a super senior. But I actually don't know, because I didn't hit me yet. It did not hit me at all that I'm a senior. But it does feel good, because I'm about to leave the school and go out in the real world.
It feels terrifying to be a senior. I don't know how else to describe it. It's all coming to an end.
Nervous, excited. It feels like just yesterday that I came to college. I think the last 4 years almost of my life here at Green Mountain have been some of the most transformative years of my life. I wouldn't take any of it back. And I think it's prepared me for the real world. We'll see. I'm just excited to get on to the next thing and see where the wind blows.
It's kind of taken a little while for me to actually feel like a senior. I feel like I just came here. But I feel I'm finally starting to realize how much I've actually grown and changed since when I came here, and how when I came here I'm a little bit more insecure about like what I, how to express my feelings, how to communicate with people, and where I would be going after college. But now I feel like I have become a person capable of navigating the world like outside. And I think that's the biggest thing that I've noticed about being a senior, is that I have a lot more confidence and in myself and my opinions and ability to like act out.
My first day on campus, I met up with my friend Will, my friend Andrew. We're all in that general freshman haze, you know? We're running around campus looking for friends, looking for a good time. I remember for a while we're like, so I guess there's a thing called the river, and we spent like 2 hours trying to find it, just like down all the different pathways. Like we know it's in this direction. We hear the call of people having a good time somewhere, but we couldn't find it for a long time. So a lot of it was just spent getting lost and getting to know each other, which in its own respect was pretty important, all things considered.
So it happened in the middle of the night, because I was coming back from New York. The international students were coming to pick me up at the train station. And so I arrived on campus in the middle of the night. I met the first international students, I met my roommate, I had a random experience meeting my roommate in the middle of the night, him coming back from kind of a party, and I had no bed sheets or no pillows. I thought that I would find them, but I didn't find anything, so I was sleeping on a bare mattress, and he helped me out. He gave me all the things that he had second, and then the next day I was just discovering this new place.
So I was an international student. I mean, I'm still an international student, and we had to come on campus a week before everyone. So I came to campus. It was very empty, and no one was there except these, like a group of students playing beach volleyball. And I just walk up to them, and I'm like, "Hey, can I play?" Because it was just weird, because no one was around, and I was just left there in my room. So yeah, that was my first day. And we played, and they motivated me to actually try to get into the team. So, and I ended up playing for the team for 2 years, so it was worth it.
My first day on campus, I think I was like one of the first people here, because I got here early, because I was flying out from San Francisco. And I think I was like the only person in Vogue, and I remember having kind of doubts because nobody was there, and I was like, where am I? What did I just get myself into? And then the next day, I woke up to my roommate and his whole family walking in while I was still asleep in bed. And I got to meet him. And I think we did all the, you know, stuff that freshmen do, signing up, getting an ID card, all of that. I remember the weather was beautiful. And then I think Wilderness Challenge was the next day. And so just preparing for that and meeting people, I don't know, it was a blast, yeah.
Oh, I remember my first day very well. I was a mess. Both my parents came and dropped me off at campus, and I can remember they pulled their cars up in front of Bogue, and the whole unloading process took like a half an hour, and I had never really left my family for an extended period of time, let alone 2 months. And between getting dropped off and then Thanksgiving break, and it was very emotional. But then I arrived early because of Wilderness Challenge, so I met a pretty fun core group of people, and I hung out with like 5 guys that night, and 3 of them are my best friends now, which is kind of crazy, but it was amazing.
I do think there is a lot of value in the college experience, living closely with people, being independent from your family if you're living on the campus or closer to campus and away from your house. I think all these things are valuable life experiences, but I think at the expense that it is, it's not always the right thing for everyone, especially because academic environments aren't always the right thing for people, especially in certain disciplines. But I think it was worth it for me. It was definitely something that like I value.
I'm incredibly lucky to even have had this opportunity to come to school, and a lot of people don't get that opportunity, and I would not take it back. I think everybody should have the opportunity to go to college, and it's completely worth it.
I had a passion before coming to college. Like, I knew I wanted to do something for the world. I knew I wanted to make a change, but I was unsure about how to go about it, but even about the realities of how to go about these things. So college was my interference with the actual world and how things really work out. So I would say yes, college was definitely worth it.
I was really scared about the transition from high school to college and being on my own and being responsible for myself. But I think that it's not even an academic experience as much as it's just a life building experience.
It was worth it coming to college. My world totally expanded by being here, and I didn't even realize that I was closed off to some of the things that I had brought into my life, but I've learned so much and I've gained a lot of confidence and leadership, and I've made a lot of incredible connections and established relationships with people that I think are gonna stick with me for my life.
It's totally worth going to college, at least in my experience, because more and more I stay here, I realize that you are in a bubble, but you're at the same time protected from the outside world while learning how to the tools to get around it once you get out. And so totally worth it in terms of the connections you make, the professors you meet, the experiences that you have, and just that aspect of naive kind of life.
One bad habit that I learned in college was that I do not to like just get in a routine of doing nothing. Always make sure you're doing something. Get out your comfort zone. Do something that scares you every day. Not something that's gonna like really terrify you. Just something that would make you uncomfortable, but that isn't like hazardous or dangerous, you know.
Coffee drinking, requiring coffee in the morning, and then yeah, it's just try to minimize that if possible.
Bad habits happen in college, but those bad habits happening in college prevents you and gives you the knowledge to not have those bad habits later on in life. There's a learning curve coming to college, you know, and when people come here initially, it's like for a lot of people the first time they've ever been away from their parents, and a lot of people go nuts. And it's about balancing that with everything else that you're trying to do and accomplish. And so bad habits develop, absolutely, but if not now, then when?
Time management. It's pretty special to be in a place where there's so much academic opportunity, but there's also so much opportunity for, you know, socially interacting with people, meeting people, doing fun things. And so just for the first time in my life, really like trying to manage my time in a way where I can do both. It's been difficult, but I've gotten better at it.
Honestly, just putting yourself out of your comfort zone and over again, delving into groups of people that make you nervous or that you don't know so well, and just establishing trust with them and getting to know them over and over, and then finding out that what you thought you knew may not be totally right, and learning and growing and doing that overall with other people while you're also studying and learning about the world and your contribution to it is just really intense.
The culture shock when I first got here, and how to actually transition and to deal with the different cultures and the different paradigm shift while I was at the school, and I'm still dealing with it, you know, so.
Being self-motivated and self-regulating is really important, because once you get into a college environment, it's kind of hard for people to kind of manage for you, and especially in a place like this where it can be very isolating in the winter months when like you're all in your dorm rooms and there's not that many people around, just maintaining like the things that make you happy and pursuing your interests by yourself, whatever like social issues are happening and complications, I think is like the most important thing. Just keep up the self motivation and interest.
Keep an open mind. I would say a lot of college is academics, but a lot of college is dealing with people whose opinions you may vehemently disagree with, but people like that will always exist in your life. And there are going to be those people that you're going to disagree with, but you need to make it work, because more than anything else, we're grown up. We're like really pre-adults, and dealing with people, dealing with those tough situations is a skill that you need to get down pretty well if you're going to be successful in the long run.
Experience things you have never experienced before, step out your comfort zone and push those limits, get out of those barriers and those routines that you were stuck in the city or like anywhere you was at, and just start talking to people that you never thought you would speak to before, interact with people you never thought you would interact with, listen to somebody's story, you know, and start going off campus a lot and just go experience life off campus as well as on campus.
Not to choose a school that will put them too far in debt. If you get a lot of financial aid to go somewhere, you should go, because if you're happy where you are studying, then that's all that matters. Your undergrad degree doesn't really make a difference in the long term.
On the first day of classes, introduce yourself to the professor. My name, where I'm from, just have a short conversation with them, because that can go a long way, just forming a personal connection. After my freshman year, I kind of learned that the hard way. You don't just want to be, I mean, you're not your ID number at the school. That's not what I'm trying to say, but just like forming, in addition to just their professor knowing your name and your academic standing in their class, like really try to formulate a personal connection, because you never know when you're gonna need a reference or a possible job down the road.
Be free to explore, honestly. Like, don't just come to college thinking that you know what's going on, or you either know what you want or you don't know what you want. Just be open to whatever and go with the flow, honestly, yeah.
I'm ready. I am scared, but it's the kind of fear that propels me forward. It's kind of this unknown anxiety about the uncertainty of the future, and it's not a crippling anxiety. It's kind of like the feeling of butterflies in a good way.
It feels terrifying. I feel like it all has a time frame, and everything has an expiration date. So all of the things that I'm taking part in here, or the friends that I'm making and have made, I can just like sense that our time together is coming to a close, and it's really scary.
I'm terrified of graduating.
Something I learned, not academic related, from being at college is probably the ability to form lasting friendships. The ability to know that if I'm ever in a rut, I can find people that can help me through that. But at the same time, learning how to be on my own, that's a huge one for me. I'm a very social person, and something I've struggled with is surrounding myself with people all the time because it's comfortable. And so just learning how to be by myself and be okay with that, that's been a big learning experience for me. And I think it's valuable going out into the real world and knowing that nobody's gonna hold your hand, and you gotta just tough it out and live.
That sense of a community, I think that GMC was like really helped me to understand that it's important to have a community with you, whatever path you take in life. Like, it's important to have that support, whether it's from a friend, a family, or just classmates. It really, really is important in life. So, yeah.
I had the opportunity to do two really unique study abroads that are offered through GMC, and I think that being able to travel and experience different places and different communities and extremely diverse groups of people, that was kind of removed from GMC, but then what I learned and will be with me for the rest of my life is the ability to take your experience from one place and relate it to another. So I could take what I learned, for example, at the Arva Institute in Israel, about environmental policy in the Middle East, and then bring it back and apply it to my classes at GMC. So just being able to take experiences from one area and bring it to the other is something that will be with me for the rest of my life.
Since I'm interdisciplinary studies major, anthropology and adventure ed, I'm kind of like figuring out which direction I want to really go with that. So I'll probably be doing some seasonal work out west, because I know that I want to be in the Pacific Northwest because it's beautiful. And that's about it so far.
So I have one ultimate goal. The ultimate goal is to have my own school. And the school is going to focus on civic engagement, activism, social justice, community building, conflict resolution. So that's the main goal. And I just, from here to now, I'm just planning those things out. Like, I think I'm going to go to graduate school for conflict resolution, or teaching, or school administration. Or I'm just going to go find a job. Some jobs is dealing with either marketing, media, activism, social justice, or being inside of a school doing something with children.
I'm a philosophy major, so the natural answer would be flipping burgers. But I want to do a lot of things. I'm planning to move to Burlington. I've already started looking for jobs up there, anything I can get, really. I want to live and work for a while, and then in the next couple years, I want to go to grad school. Or law school. I haven't decided yet, but one of those routes. I never want to stop being a student. Hope when the water
rises, you build. Full of opportunity, stress, self-made stress most of the time, and staying curious. Whether it's with people or within the classes that you're in.
Opportunity. You need to seize it when you can. Inertia. If you're not moving forward, you're moving backward, and it's important to keep on swimming, you know? And I guess patience. Patience with a lot of things. Patience with people, and patience with yourself. It's easy to get frustrated and become flabbergasted over any number of things, but a lot of times you really just gotta like cool down, accept, and deal. And it's a lot easier said than done, but it is an important thing.
Ventress would definitely be one. Literally and just holistically, the experience of experiencing college.
Transformative. Incredibly fun. A huge learning experience. And very little sleep.
It's different. Growth. And experienced. I wish that I could witness all your joy and all your pain. How we met. This is one of the first days of school, and we had a meeting with our RA, and we was going around introducing ourselves, and it got to him. I introduced myself as Corey Fletcher. I'm from Philadelphia, and people call me Fletch. And his turn came around. The first thing this man said was, "My name's Pretty Boy," and just stopped talking.
Did I say that?
Yes, you said that. That's the reason why I remembered you, and I kept calling him Pretty Boy for an entire week. Yes.
I don't remember that at all, but I believe it happened, but...
My name is Pretty Boy. It just was quiet, dead silent for the rest of the day.
Damn, dude.
Oh, that was how I met Matt.